Dosage on NAC. Okay, I recommend the augmented NAC and dosages one capsule a day to start off with, then one capsule twice a day after 4 or 5 days, one and then two capsules twice a day. I take that myself, okay, because it will maintain health or create health. But that's what I recommend. Regular NAC is wonderful. It's only 15% effective. So the augmented NAC, you're getting a bigger bang for the buck. It's a little bit more expensive. And I do mean a little bit, okay, but it's worth doing. You should do that for 3 to 6 months. And then a maintenance dose would be one or two capsules a day. What other substances besides augmented NAC binds a spike protein? There's a lot of them that claim to, okay. I'd rather not go into it now because it's numerous. And I'm not sure of the efficacy. I am very sure of the efficacy about the augmented NAC. And if you're going to get this for yourself or for a loved one, or if you're a practitioner and you're deciding on a single product that's worth it, okay, I recommend the augmented NAC. There's other substances, high dose B1 therapy and so forth. But I've noticed with that, as good as it is you have to take regular B complex and you have to take electrolytes and then there's other things you have to take, which becomes a protocol unto itself. With the augmented NAC, you're drinking water and you're just taking that with the other parameters of foundational treatment, it becomes a lot easier. Remember, the less things you have people take, the better compliance they're going to get because anybody will do anything for 2 weeks. But beyond that, you're looking for long-term compliance because that's where the healing is going to take place. It takes time. Some people think that it's still the pill for the ill, but it takes time. Does NAC increase histamine in the body? I'm not aware that it does. Okay, I've never seen anything that points in that direction. NAC combined with glutamate will create glutathione, and that's one of the mechanisms of controlling glutamate, which is a big problem, especially if somebody has a polymorphic GAD enzyme, glutamate decarboxylase, which takes glutamate and converts it to GABA, which is inhibitory, which you use to calm your brain. But high glutamate in high enough numbers will cause seizures. It's nasty. And on the neurotransmitter test, you'll see it. So one of the ways of correcting that is to use L-theanine. And there's a product that the liposomal product by Quicksilver Scientific that has GABA with L-theanine that will go directly into the brain. But using NAC or augmented NAC that will combine with glutamate and create glutathione. Okay. That's one way it's binding glutamate, so it drops the glutamate down. Is NAC a histamine liberator? What about affecting mood, glutamate, dopamine? Thank you. Okay. NAC is not a histamine liberator. Okay. And the way it affects mood is by binding glutamate. Okay. Which will bring down that excitatory neurotransmitter. Remember that the excitatory neurotransmitter gives rise to things like OCD, ADD, schizophrenia, all the excitatory disorders. Okay. And it will create glutathione, which is your master antioxidant, which will start scarfing up free radicals, which are also a big problem. That's oxidative stress. And you bring your oxidative stress down lower, and that's going to have a positive effect on your entire health. So I don't know that NAC is a histamine liberator. I've never run into that. Remember, I could be wrong. Okay. I always invite people to send me, information so I can correct and learn.